Welcome in SST class of class 6th. Good morning students. Take out your geography book, lesson number 7, North America, physical features, page number 74. Students, in previous video, we have discussed the political division of North America. I hope you have revised it. Today, I am going to teach you the North America physical features. Physical means a variety of landforms in North America, as you people have read in your lower classes. Various types of landforms in India. Today our topic is North America and its physical features. North America is a land of contrast. Look at this map. The western part of North America is mountainous or rocky. Southern eastern part of North America is plain. Whereas central part of North America is covered with plateau. Let us see the objectives of the lesson. Introduction, physical features of North America, the Western Cordillera, the Eastern Cordillera or the Appalachian Highlands, Central Plains or Prairies, the Canadian Shield or the Laurentian Plateau, major mountains and plateaus, water bodies, deserts, gorge, canyon, and geyser. Let us see today's objectives. Introduction and Western Cordillera. Let us see some new words. Island, a piece of a land surrounded by water. Gulf, a gulf is a large inlet from the ocean into the landmass. Waterfall, water falling from a height. Lake, an area filled with water and surrounded by land. Cordillera, chain of mountains. Let's do reading of North America physical features. Great contrast. Contrast means variation, are viewed in the continent of North America. There are a variety of landforms or physical features. North America has evergreen forest, snow-covered mountains, rivers, islands, lakes, gulfs, deserts, waterfalls, plains, and rugged plateau. Rugged means rough, with a lot of rocks without any plants. The continent can thus be roughly divided into four physical divisions, namely the Western Cordillera, second, the Eastern Cordillera or the Appalachian Highlands, Central Plains or Prairies, the Canadian Shield or the Laurentian Plateau. Students, North America has different landforms like forest, snow-covered mountains, peaks, deserts, plains, and plateaus. Look at this picture. It's Mount McKinley, which is the highest peak of Western Cordillera and North America. This is River Mississippi, which is the longest river of North America. This is the group of island of North America. This is the Superior Lake, which is the largest lake of North America. This is the Gulf of Mexico. This is the driest desert of North America. Let us start reading of physical features of North America. First physical division is the Western Cordillera. Cordillera means the chain of mountains. Cordillera is a Spanish word which means a chain of parallel mountains. The Western Cordillera is the extensive mountain system located in the western part of North America. Like the Himalayas, the Western Cordillera is the young fold mountains that run from Alaska in the north to Panama in the south. You can see in this map, Western Cordillera runs from north of North America, that is Alaska, to south of North America, that is Panama. It is shown with brown color. You can see in this map, there are many ranges of Western Cordillera. Cordillera means a chain of mountains. Western Cordillera extends from Alaska to Panama. Mountains of Western Cordillera are recently formed. Let us continue our reading. This chain of parallel mountains occupies nearly one-third of total area of North America. The Western Cordillera has roughly three parallel ranges. It is about 6,500 kilometers long and about 1,600 kilometers broad. The height of these mountain ranges varies between 2,500 meters and 4,000 meters above the sea. Highest mountain range in the Western Cordillera is the Rocky Mountains, that is located towards the east. This range makes up the greater part of the Cordillera. A large part of North America is occupied by Western Cordillera. Western Cordillera has three parallel ranges. Average height of the mountains of Western Cordillera is 2,500 to 4,000 meters. It is about 6,500 meters long and 1,500 meters wide. Western Cordillera covers an extensive area of mountain ranges, intermountain, basin, and plateaus. Rocky Mountains located in the east of Western Cordillera. It is also known as American Cordillera. Let's start our reading. The other important ranges in the Western Cordillera are the Alaska Range, which lies in the north, the Cascade Range lying in the middle, the Coastal Range that lies along the coast, the Sierra Nevada that lies inland. Parallel to the Coastal Range and the Sierra Madre that lies to the south, stretching through the length of Central America. Let us see through map. In extreme north, Alaska Range is situated. The three parallel ranges of Western Cordillera are Rocky Mountains, Cascade Range and Coastal Range. To the south of the Western Cordilleras, the ranges are Sierra Nevada and Sierra Madre. Mount McKinley, 6,193 meters, the highest peak in the North America, is in the Alaska Range. Mount McKinley is the highest peak of Western Cordillera, which remains frozen throughout the year.
Your homework to do these questions on fair copy, and have a nice day. Thank you very much.